Madam Speaker. The currently 2016 and 2017 South Korea's core agenda in democracy is the trust, responsibility. We have been continuously told you when you lose the trust as a conservative party and conservative member, we say this, that's ultimate failure of democracy, that's ultimate failure of protecting conservative rights. The problem of government side today is that they just simply merely support Ahn Cheol-Soo's policy without necessarily giving any clear linkage whatsoever that has to do with conservative ideas. They just simply assert these things are really good, but all that compared to, they continuously criticize the other candidates such as Moon Jae-in, Hong Joon-kyo, or Shin Sang-jo or whatnot, without giving us any clear comparison, without drawing a clear picture what kind of conservative value ultimately in the end they want to protect. We say for these core reasons, government can never win this debate at the end of the day. So let me clarify this debate in 3 minutes. First of all, let's talk about whether or not Ahn Cheol-Soo is really a responsible person to actually protect the conservative value. Second of all, let's talk about whether or not Ahn Cheol-Soo really fits with the responsibility. Third of all, let's talk about whether or not Ahn Cheol-Soo is a really trustable person that leads the future of our nation, South Korea. But before that, three reasons why our government team ultimately lose this debate. As I told you in the introduction, first of all, they continue to say that these other candidates such as Hong Joon-kyo or Moon Jae-in, these people are really bad, and it is not negotiable, Mr. Madam Speaker. But the problem is, basically, in the principal level, when they negate that Ahn Cheol-Soo himself is really a person they should support, they never focus why principal level engagement entails context, that when he actually is really shaken, he can actually prove that he's going to fulfill his policy. We think in principal level you should not go for that politician to
begin with.
Because the core conservative democratic value tells you that you need to make a trust system, responsible system should be fulfilled. But in second level analysis, we say that it is really inefficient and they completely ignore our cases by saying that Taeyoung already told you that Ahn Cheol-Soo is going to make this change the education system until 2022. Without not proving specific mechanism, without not engaging with the education system, security system was a shifting stance of stock in this issue. They never proposed any why these things are really related to conservative values and how these things can protect our society. That's exactly the reason why government team can never participate in this debate. So basically, they're going to move on to first clash whether or not Ahn Cheol-Soo is really the one who fits the conservative value. Mr. Madam Speaker, after President Park Geun-hye has been impeached, the core agenda is this. Basically, when President Park Geun-hye has promised us that she's going to make a creative economy for these things to be fulfilled, the reason why she was ultimately lost the trust is because she cannot actually fulfill these ideas. However, comparatively, say that the reason why we should not vote for Ahn Cheol-Soo himself, in and of itself, is because he cannot clearly promise and cannot exactly make a clear mechanism how these things can be actually fulfilled. In other words, he lacks the visibility and he actually cannot actually vision and clearly make a response to the question of other candidates such as Moon Jae or using it in TV debate, and actually this was actually not clearly pictured in the reality in the status quo. So that's exactly the reason why we tell you that Ahn Cheol-Soo himself is really not a responsible person. And if you really vote for that person in the future, we say that South Korea's future will become in a dire future because you cannot actually make a change to begin with. But furthermore, we tell you in outside opposition, that we cannot really understand, they just simply push us and we rather should support for Hong Joon-kyo. But the problem is this, basically if you really don't like Hong Joon-kyo, then Minyoung already told you that Ahn Cheol-Soo already has a lower popularity compared to Hong Joon-kyo. So we could not necessarily understand why we should actually support for Hong Joon-kyo if he has really not down compared to that candidate. And furthermore, is this, they say that very dismissive response coming from government side, that other candidates are really have a non-negotiable value. But if that's the case, they need to clearly prove to us any important reasons to conserve the values, why Ahn Cheol-Soo itself is really important. The fact of the matter is, Prime Minister started to talk about why Ahn Cheol-Soo is important after 6 minutes of clash over. And the Deputy Prime Minister tried to talk about why Ahn Cheol-Soo is important after 5 minutes of clash over. And not clearly prove to us, they just simply give a negative why the government is already running away from this motion, not clearly give us a clear comparison as to why it is really important in this case. But we're clearly engaging into that issue. We tell you that responsibility is really important in our current context. Leader of opposition, Minyoung Rho, told you in four-level analysis, first of all, he told you that national security in and of itself is important. In terms of fighting against DPRK, we tell you that basically this whole entire group, Ahn Cheol-Soo itself, is surrounded by Park Ji-won because that person is already from Dongmin-dang Party. That was to say, when even if Ahn Cheol-Soo becomes elected, he will lose the support from conservative governments and these people because he's surrounded by these liberal parties and liberal shits. So we think that that's the reason why you can actually get the support from conservative people. But Governor Minyoung already told you, in terms of welfare system, in terms of state intervention, Ahn Cheol-Soo intervenes into these issues so much. He already told you very clearly in our stance, the core conservative value is that we should minimize state intervention and we should make our conservative value as it is. But they continuously never engage in our context why these things are not very important and why these things are actually very important, although they were very like they really think so. So that's exactly the reason why if you vote for Ahn Cheol-Soo, we cannot actually guarantee his responsibility and his leadership in our country. So that's exactly the reason why we tell that Ahn Cheol-Soo is not really a considerable option, and that's the reason why we say he doesn't have any responsibility from the get-go. What is your answer?
So, should you vote for an individual who's only 100% compatible with all the beliefs that you have?
I'm not saying that we should vote for 100% relative level when he actually does not have any evidence and does not have any clear comparatives, as we told you, alternatives. And we are not necessarily supporting using it, but in terms of comparing the answers, we can tell you at least using means sub and these national security and supporting these kind of values is at least better than Ahn Cheol-Soo, who's really shaky and does not have any responsibility from the start. But second of all, we think that Ahn Cheol-Soo himself does not fit the conservative value because first of all, we told you that conservative value should be based on minimized state intervention, but he intervenes so much. But second of all, we tell you basically Ahn Cheol-Soo himself can actually becoming the same example as President Park Geun-Hye, who was already impeached, and can actually fulfill her promise. So in that parallel example, we already see that there is negative consequences in our nation if you just simply vote for Ahn Cheol-Soo to begin with. But furthermore, in terms of leading the future, when we actually see their best case scenario at best, we say that Ahn Cheol-Soo is voted in their president, but we say that there are negative externalities and negative characteristics of Ahn Cheol-Soo who cannot guarantee the conservative core value of our protecting our nation. But at least on our side, the reason why we should not vote for Ahn Cheol-Soo itself is that he cannot actually prove why he should be very leading our country. And Ahn Cheol-Soo itself is really shaky in terms of the Liberal Party and Conservative Party, and he is already losing much support from the very get-go. So that's exactly the reason why we say that Ahn Cheol-Soo is not a person that we should believe in. So if you really want to protect our nation's conservative value, as a conservative, please vote for opposition.